What's going on, creative family? It's Dustin Volkma. Today we're talking about a 60-second method to do sky replacements in Photoshop the easy way. Make sure to subscribe, smack that like button, and I will see you guys in Photoshop. All right, guys, here we are in Photoshop with probably one of the most common types of sky replacements that I get asked to do while I'm retouching other people's photos. And that has to do with these overcast skies. And in this case, we actually have a pond here that's in front that's catching the sky reflection as well. So let's go ahead and dive right into this. So first things first, when I get started with a sky replacement like this, what I generally like to do is press Control or Command R to make sure that I have the rulers here on my document so that I can just click inside of this ruler here up top. And I can just set that guide that it will create right around where the horizon line is for my photo. And then assuming that I have a sky that I like, which I had already found one here for this example. And let's pull that in. And once we get the sky placed here, what I'll generally do is just press Control or Command and start to drag this, pressing Shift so that it just moves straight up in my document. And I'll set that horizon line there to match the rough guide that I had set previously. Now that that's set, we can get to the true magic of this method of sky replacements, which is using the blend if. And how we can do that is just double clicking the sky replacement layer. And then you have the blend if here. So we currently have it set to gray. We'll get into more of an advanced tutorial on exactly how to use blend if and all of these functions and features in a later video. But for this one here, we're just going to use the underlying layer, and we want to remove that sky from all of the darker, or say, shadows in the scene, everything except for the highlights. What we're focusing on first is the sky that's up here, and so we can bring this down to a decent range, and then press Alt or Option, and then click and drag these little handles out. And then once you play with those just a little bit, you'll see that we start to get a really nice feather on the edge there. So we can press OK. And now you'll see that we have a little bit on this side there. So what I generally like to do is try to play with blend modes. And in this case, we don't really need a soft light, but I will go to multiply to see if we can work with this a little bit darker, which should be fine for this overlay as it's not really a bright sunny day. It's just really getting to know what blend modes work best for your workflow. So with these here, we can just do our best to pull those out. And I think that should work fairly well. Yep. So right there, blend if, it works pretty good. And now we have all of this crud that's down here on the bottom. So what we can do there is press L for our lasso tool. And I usually set about a 10 pixel feather. I use that quite often for a lot of different selections that I do. And so we can create, or we can just create a garbage mask here that goes right around this tree line. And then the rest of the photo. And then from there, we can just press Alt or Option and click our layer mask button so that now we're just masking out everything that's in that upper part of the sky there. Now at this point, it's really good to just click your overlay off and on here, and you can see that primarily in this one little bit of tree there, it's not really noticeable to the eye without knowing it's there, but if you run into those issues, you can just use your brush tool with a black brush, and you can paint that out of these trees in this area. So we can just make sure that we have some of that painted out a little bit. Make sure that there's nothing else that's happening that's getting hit pretty hard by that. I don't think there is. I think that was it. That's just the basic sky replacement for this top one. Now, what I would normally do is actually bump the exposure on that just a little bit in the midtones. And so I will press Control or Command M. That brings up my curves. I'll just grab a midtone point here and we can just bring that up a little bit so that it's not too dark. But it will still read really nice when we get to grading. Now I always do this stuff here before I get to any part of my grading or color toning process. And that's primarily because it really helps bring everything together prior to adding any extra color information into the photo. Now, when it comes to the reflection down here in the water, I'm actually not too concerned with what's underneath them in this bridge, because you have just enough of windbreak up there and ripples going on that there's not too much detail that you would see. Whereas in this front area here, you would expect to see some of the sky reflecting. And so in this case, what we can do is press Control or Command J to duplicate this layer and Control T for the free transform. And then we can just do flip vertical. And now we can bring this down. And we're going to be affecting everything now at the bottom edge of this photo. And then what I will do, let's see here. It actually works quite well. There's not really anything that's causing too much of an issue. I will paint this out of this area here just using my black brush on the layer mask. Or sorry, my white brush. Just add that detail back in there. And because we used that blend if previously, it's actually doing quite a good job of masking everything else off so that the sky is not overlaying on all of that. All right, so now that we've actually gone through and done a little bit more of an explanatory process in this here, I can just work through this real time and maybe just do a few key call outs, but show you guys what it might look like in more of a real time fashion. And so go ahead and we'll set up my rough guide and pull in my sky overlay, match up those horizon lines, place that image. I generally use multiply, so set that there. We can double click that layer, head into blend if, find a range that works pretty well here, click OK, L for the lasso tool, just do a rough garbage mask there all the way around the parts that I don't need, alter option, click the layer mask. So that would cover the top piece there. Controller Command J to duplicate it. Controller Command T for free transform. Right click, flip vertical, move this guy down here to the bottom of the image. And then at this point, I just use this layer mask. And I can remove this from the parts that I don't actually need it in here. And that's it. And now we're ready to move on to the next step in the grading or retouching process. All right, guys, so that wraps up this tutorial on my 60-second method to replacing skies in Photoshop the easy way. Now, of course, this was a bit more of a practical scenario and something that I use quite often when I'm doing this type of work for clients. So we'll get into more advanced topics a little bit later on how to maybe match your entire scene to a sky overlay that you want to use and vice versa. So make sure to subscribe, click that like button. If you guys have any comments or questions, just feel free to leave those down in the comment section. I'll get to that stuff as soon as possible. I'm looking forward to seeing you guys in the next video.